Hi guys, Aaron from Solace here with part four of different ways of creating and configuring queues in Solace. Okay, so I've got three queues that I've made here, one using the PubSub Plus Manager, the GUI tool, one using the SEMP Management API, doing it programmatically, and one using CLI, our command line interface. So do you know the fourth way of creating a queue in Solace? Well, it's actually going to be using our client APIs, or SDKs, if you will. You can either find them on our downloads page at solace.com/downloads, or head over to our GitHub page at github.com/solace samples, and you'll find samples for all of our different kind of main APIs. So all of our kind of enterprise or kind of Solace APIs have the ability to create and provision queues and then add topic subscriptions to them. Here's some links to our documentation. I'll put them in the description down below on provisioning endpoints and adding subscriptions to those endpoints, so queue endpoints in this case. So you can see that we don't have a test queue 4 here. I'm a Java guy, so I've gone ahead and downloaded the Java samples and I've loaded them into Eclipse here. I'm looking at the topic to queue mapping sample because it's probably about the closest one to what we need to be able to do. I'm not going to go through all the code. I'm just going to kind of focus in on a couple important parts. So here's where we actually connect into the Solace broker. Here's the name of the queue that I'm going to be provisioning. I'm just going to replace that with test queue 4 to match our other ones. Maybe I'm going to change some of the permissions here on this. I'm going to say we'll be able to consume. Set the quota to be 400 because I'm kind of going up in size. And that's about it. This is where it actually goes ahead and creates the queue on the broker. And this next step here is where it actually maps the topic to the queue. So we'll make that match our other subscriptions as well. So I'm going to go ahead and run this. One thing to check, though, before you do this is your client username, the profile that's associated with it, needs to have the ability, kind of the permissions to be able to create endpoints. So in my case, I'm using the default client profile for my message VPN. And you can see here that I have allow client to create endpoints is enabled. So this allows client usernames, data application clients, to be able to connect and create guaranteed endpoints on the broker. Now, one other cool thing, if you click on advanced settings, when you create endpoints, you can actually use what we call template queue to create the endpoint. So you can say you want to make a whole bunch of queues that all kind of look the same way. You can create a template queue with your quota and everything kind of pre-configured, TTL and all that stuff. And then whenever an application creates a queue, it'll use that, it'll copy the default values from that template queue automatically. So that's kind of a neat feature if you're checking that out. Anyway, back to our queues. Let's go ahead and run our application. I'm going to step through it in debug mode just to we can see things happening in slow motion. So this is where it's actually going to go ahead and provision the queue. So step one, come back over here and refresh. There's my new queue that I've just created. We can go into it. If you look in the settings, you can see that it actually has an owner now. Since I was creating this with a client application, it uses the username of whatever client application. So rather than kind of a management created queue. Under subscriptions, we still need to add our subscription. So that's the next line of the code. Here is where we create the topic inside the API. And this is where we actually add the subscription to the queue. Come back over here, refresh. There we go. So a fourth way of creating queues and adding subscriptions in Solace. Okay, so you've made it to the end. Four different ways of creating and configuring queues in Solace. I'm wondering how many people actually watched all four of these things. Actually, there's two other ways, legacy ways, that I didn't mention, solidmin and sempv1 for some of our older users out there. So actually there's six, but I didn't want to go into that old legacy stuff. So I hope you found this video series useful. Please subscribe to our channel for more tech videos like this. Give it a like if you like these videos. And yeah, thanks for watching and see you next time.